Let me now introduce our next speaker. Dr. Qazi Zahid Iqbal is one of the prominent lawyers, again in the Supreme Court of Bangladesh. He's also one of the panel lawyers of Bangladesh Legal Aid Services Trust, called BLAST. Ex-vice chairperson of Bangladesh Women Health Coalition and the member of Bangladesh History Society. I think all of this really makes for a well-rounded experience that he can bring to us. And we're very, very happy to welcome him. He has a number of publications on legal issues in Bangladesh. Please, Dr. Qazi Zahid Iqbal, the mic is yours.
Okay. Thank you, Vidya Dinkar, the moderator. And my heartfelt congratulations to Jyotirmoy Borua, my colleague in the High Court, for his nice presentation. And definitely my respect to Syed Arizan Hassan Apa for one of our iconic activists in various issues. And my gratitude to School of People's Law and Bangladesh Working Group on External Debt for their arrangement of this webinar. Thank you all of you for having patience. And let me go to the book again after the very fascinating presentation by Rizwana Apa. Let me see the book again. There is a proposition that energy law have three dimensions. First is energy policy and energy security. The second is economic issue, and third is environmental issue. But always we see the law, policy, and economic issues always get privileged over the environmental issues. To enhance the energy security and economy, the law takes its position in favor of the energy-related technology instead of environment. In Bangladesh, there is an culture of energy policy which has been revised and changed time to time. The policy is not environment friendly in a strict sense. Moreover, quick enhancement of electricity and energy supply act 2010, as Jyotirmoy mentioned and elaborately explained, has made room for unfair practice by incorporating immunity clause in it, if anyone want to do so. We can see section 9 and 10 for instance. In section 9 and 10, there is an immunity immunity in the law that no one can challenge any action of the committee before any court. We can mention here that the immunity culture is not new in Bangladesh. Constitution also made room for it. Article 46, for instance, we can see that the room for immunity has been mentioned in the Constitution. But in practical aspects, corruption is not at all immune under the Act. There are also instances of strike down the immunity by the court, as mentioned by the Jyotirmoy Borua already. So still there is a scope to challenge the immunity if there is any allegation of corruption in the process. Any kind of immunity clause in any law is a violation of fundamental principle of the constitutional spirit. I have the opinion that there is always a scope for challenge any law containing any section ultra vires to the constitutional spirit. every stakeholder should keep an eye on such type of law. And now, finally, I can mention about the quick rental issue. It is unbelievable. Its unbelievable expenditure should be redressed by the authority concerned, because it is bad. It creates bad instances for the image of the country. Actually, Jyotirmoy has already mentioned all the things, and subsequently, APA already elaborately explained from the political perspective, leaving a little room for me to say more something, add more something about the law. I just want to mention here that if we want to challenge the immunity-related issues before the court, still there is room. And if we together create the situation that we can challenge it in the court, we can do it. That's all from my part at this moment. And if there is any question, I will answer it.